Dead end. Oh yeah. It's on the ridge up there? Yeah.
That's where I stopped to take a picture of you guys.
Huh?
That's where I stopped to take a picture of you guys.
Not on the road, we're talking about the ridge up there. We're a little closer. See the ridge up there? Where we were at last night.
The ridge where it comes over? You see the scar in the right underneath the ridge?
Yeah.
That's where we were at last night. We were thinking about camping there.
Oh, yeah.
That goes on to the tunnel over there. Yep.
that rock, huh?
Yeah, I did. Good thing the slowly pedal was down.
You go to that high side and cut down, it was like, whoa!
Yeah. It's like, do I want to go over the edge or do I want to hit the rock?
Yeah. You may hit the rock and go over the edge.
Thank you.
Let's have steak for dinner. Let's just eat something like sandwich or hamburger or
bound to happen. That wasn't that bad.
Oh, you ain't right.
That's right. I'm trying not to ride this time.
It's got rock inside. It's holding it tight.
You good? Okay. Any ruts.
Yeah.
This was one of the funnest spots.
Yeah, what, did you come right?
Yeah.
I think I bunny hopped it.
they hit that go across? That mark on it?
I don't know. Maybe they stepped on it.
They stepped on it. Another good way to get on your bike instead of getting on from the low side, get on the high side.
Ran. That's the only way through until it...
Well, the trail opens back up right over here.
Okay.
It gets real fun up here, a lot of shoots.
We finished our trip, that last ride down the road there, next to traffic, wind sweeping past us was the nicest feelings of accomplishment that I think I've felt so far. We had traveled just over 55 miles the past 2 days, by either foot or by bike, climbing, pushing, dragging ourselves to the top of Mulgrave Mountain, down Captain Jack's Trail, over the places that had been washed out by the floods, and now we get to come back to sleep in a normal bed, eat a normal hamburger, and forever have these experiences and memories of our trip.
Blind, but